Because he would get married and then he'd be summer beach.
Good luck with that.
That was a really good poem. That was beautiful. I have to use my paper. Okay. Can you guys hear me okay? Great. Maybe if you callate in the back, you can hear me even better. Okay, cool.
Silencio, por favor.
Silencio, por favor.
Yes, I have seen the enemy, and it is plastered with brick, mortar, steel, wrought iron, and concrete, erected high in the sky, obelisk after Washington, monumental obelisk, the symbols for the inadequacy of impotent leaders of ineffectual governments running impudent, murderous countries, blatantly compensating for their own futile, flaccid fallacies, rendered useless by factory farm, fried fowl stuffed down deep in the bellies of the bees, dipped in grease and packed bite by self-loathing bite, feeding the hunger of archaic execration, traveling down the intestines of history, the bowels of imperialism, the entrails of God-fearing missionaries dispatched in the name of the Lord, preaching perjurous permutations of reality that we're expected to consume and digest and shit and eat again, and consume and digest and shit and eat again, until all we have left on our plates is the recycled, greenwashed, baptized, genetically modified, and radio frequency identified pile of PCs stamped with the devil's mark, Fox News, MSNBC, Clear Channel Communications, and any other babbling bustle of self-serving talking heads lying through their whitened teeth, expecting us to believe the messages and forget what we already know, asking us to deny the battle cries of Kanaka Maoli, deny the injustices upon Las Indígenas, deny the tyrannical torture of tribes, deny the pain of Palestine, deny the systemized subjugation of our sisters, deny the brutality to and from our brothers, the transmission of their messianic mind control, climaxing in the excretion that is self-hate, while co-opting ancient wisdoms, Egyptian temples, and the sacred science of sunrise and sunset, zodiac moon cycling through blood-soaked wounds, through blood-soaked sheets, through blood-soaked jeans, the cycles of feminine divine posing the largest threat, cutting with no mercy through the bullshit. But you see, I want deliverance. I don't want a FedEx delivery of patriarchal power struggle making me sign the dotted line to accept my fate that rips from me my freedom and identity, steals from me my history, lies to me and tells me that I'm not worthy, because I have walked through the valley of the shadow of doubt, and I shine the light. Shine the light so bright that rainbows were blinded and summoning clouds to create night. And in that glistening moonbow darkness, I dance naked, blood running down my thighs, dripping into the earth, stripping my body of formalities and insecurities, tearing at the soil beneath my grounded feet as they gyrate, no longer bound by gravity, no longer bound by chains of domesticity. And as my literal lifeblood sinks deeper into her core, I can feel the growth. I can smell the life. I celebrate with each kick of brilliance maturing in her womb, and I kiss her pulsating breadbasket as she clenches her strong hands into fists, dirt driving under her nails, mud parting beneath her wrists, splitting open in an orgasmic earthquake of birth. I hear her child's first cry as she screams, "Resist! Resist! Resist!"
Just me, myself, and I.
Alive with possibilities. Speaking of creative things, I'd really like y'all to focus your eyes on this ever